हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द कोर्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड डिज़ाइन। माई सेल्फ विमल सलोद फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन्वॉल्यूट। सो फर्स्ट लेट अस डिफाइन इन्वॉल्यूट। इट इज़ डिफाइंड एज अ कर्व जनरेटेड बाय द एंड ऑफ अ पीस ऑफ द थ्रेड विच इज बीइंग वाउंड और अनवाउंड from a circle or a polygon. So what happens when any string or a thread is wound or unwound from a circle or a polygon? Progressively its length is increased or decreased. If it is being wound on a circle or polygon, then progressively its length will be decreased. And if it is unwound from a circle or a polygon, progressively its length will be increasing. So let us now see the procedure to draw this type of curve. So let us start with the polygon. You know, polygon means square, triangle, square, pentagon, hexagon, all these are polygons. Let's see the given data. Draw an involute to a square of 25 mm size. Draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So here given polygon is square. So first of all, we have to draw a square of size 25 mm. Write down the corner points 1, 2, 3, and 4. Write down the dimension of the square 25 mm. Now if we want to wound a string on this square, what will be the length of the string? It will be equal to perimeter, that is 25 into 4. So the required length of string is 100 mm. So from corner number 4, from where we are beginning to wound the string, length you will take as 100 mm. 25 into 4, it means 100 mm length is the total length of the string required. Now, as we are wounding the string progressively, the length of the string will be decreased. When the string is wound on side 41, its length will be decreased by 25 mm. So P0 is the initial point where total length is 100 mm. When we wound the string on first side, that is 41 side, now length is reduced by 25 mm. So the remaining length of the string is 75 mm. Now on next side, string will be wanted. So again, the length of the string will be decreased by 25 mm. So when string is wound on side 1, 2, the remaining length of the string is 75 minus 25, that is 50 mm. Next step is string is wound on side number 2, 3. So remaining length of the string is 50 minus 25. So remaining length is 25. Corner 4 is the point where total length of the string is wounded. So now we got the points P0, P1, P2, P3 and P4. So these are the different positions of the end point of a string when it is being wounded on a square. We have to join all these points, that is locus of the end point of the string. And that locus or that curve is known as involute. So now we will join all these points with smooth freehand curve. Once it becomes proper, then we should make it thick or dark, because the main part of this drawing is involute. Now, next part of this question is draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So we have to consider any point on this curve. We are taking S point on this curve. From point S, we have to draw tangent and normal. So here we have considered S point in this segment. So center point of this segment is corner number 1. So we have to join S point, this S point, with corner number 1. And we have to extend this line into same direction up to certain length. This line is NN line and it is known as normal. We know that tangent and normal are always perpendicular to each other. So from S point, now we will draw a perpendicular line. That line is known as the tangent. So NN is normal and TT is the tangent at the given point S. Now let's see the procedure to draw an involute for a circle. Given data is draw involute of a circle of diameter 30 mm. Also draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. In case of circle, if string is rounded, then the required length of the string is equal to circumference of the circle. Here diameter is 30 mm. So circumference of the circle, that is equal to pi into 30. That would be the required length for a string for one complete rotation. Now, to draw the involute, first step is to draw a circle of diameter 30 mm. So we have to take radius 15 mm and draw a circle. We are dividing the circumference of the circle into 8 numbers of equal parts, taking one division equal to 45 degrees. Write down the division number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the division numbers. From the bottom point, we have to take the length of the string, that is circumferential length, pi into d. So total length is pi into d, pi into 30, that you have to take as total length of the string. Now, as string is being bounded on the circumference of a circle, from each and every point of the circumference, we have to draw the tangent, because when string is bounded, the position of the string at any point on the circumference of a circle is tangential position. So we are drawing from each and every point of the circumference tangents. As we have divided circumference into 8 parts, we have to also divide circumference pi d into 8 numbers of equal division. Now, draw the tangent from each and every point of the circumference of a circle. So division number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are the different positions of a string. Now, what will be the length of the string? When string is mounted, progressively its length is decreasing. So in first step, when it is mounted on point number 1, the remaining length of the string will be equal to 1p. It is the remaining length of the string. So that we have to take from point number 1 to p1. That dimension is 1 to p. That is remaining length of the string. When string is mounted up to second division, the remaining length of the string is equal to 2p0. It is 2p0, the remaining length of the string. That same length we have to take for this tangent. So that is point number p2. Now, next is division number 3. When it is bounded up to division number 3, the remaining length of string is equal to 3p0. So it is the remaining length of the string 3p0. That same length we have to take for this tangent, that is point number p3. Same procedure we have to repeat for division number 4, 5, 6 and 7. So These are the different positions of the end point of a string. When string is arrived at point number 8, the total length of the string is wound on the circumference of a circle. So that is the final position of the end piece and point of a string. Now we have to join all these points with smooth freehand curve. This curve is known as involute of a circle. Next part of this problem is to draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So we are considering any point Q on this curve. Now we are going to draw tangent and normal at point Q. Join Q point with the center point. You have to join this Q point with center point C. So now we got one additional line, that is QC. Mark midpoint of this QC line as point M. Now keep M point as center point and take compass size equal to MQ. Take compass size equal to MQ and draw a half circle which will intersect with the main circle at one point. Let's name this point as end point. Now join this end point with Q and extend it up to certain length. This NN line is normal at given point Q. Now tangent is perpendicular to normal. So from Q point, draw a perpendicular line, that is tangent. NN is normal and TT is tangent at given point Q. So it is complete procedure to draw the involute for a polygon or for a circle. And also we have seen the procedure to draw tangent and normal at any point on the given curve. Thank you very much for watching.